Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Computer Wednesday. In today's episode we're gonna take a look at a very interesting topic, that is either you should buy a pre-built system as in from Dell or HP, or you should assemble it by yourself. So let's dive right into it. First thing we have to understand, we are talking about desktop PC here. Now it's a multi-purpose tool. It's one thing that can do it all. You can have a system that can allow you to play games. You can have a system that could allow you to do video editing. You can have a system that can, you know, help you understand stock market. It could be a system where you do programming. So a desktop computer, specifically given the fact that it can handle much higher powerful components, it allows you to do it all. Now of course it's not precisely built, it's not like, you know, like a supercomputer, but you can do almost everything on a good quality desktop. That's why it's so interesting to figure out what you want to buy, because if done properly, if you purchase what you need, you know, what you should have purchased, you will be happy and you will be able to do so much more that you can't even imagine. So this is desktop PC. Now even though that desktop PC is a multi-purpose tool, we still require what we call tailoring it or custom making it. The reason for that is there is a mathematically infinite probability of how many hardware can be connected with any other hardware, simply because everything in a computer is standardized. Either you buy a Intel motherboard or you buy AMD motherboard, but they still accept the same RAM, so you can still connect whatever graphics card you want to connect to it. For this reason there is an infinite combination. Now each combination will allow you to have certain benefits and certain side effects. So you have to understand what is your need. Like a guy who does a lot of CAD simulation will not enjoy Nvidia graphics card that is not running on Quadro graphics system. He may not enjoy GTX. He will be like, okay, give me Quadro. Now imagine somebody who's doing video editing and is not doing very high end. He may not even need a graphics card. Right now AMD's onboard CPU unit, basically APU units, they are quite powerful in terms of onboard graphics. So different needs, and there are different classes also. So even though you can buy the same component, let's say a 6-core processor, there are different classes of 6-core processor. One core would be specifically built for performance, like benchmarking and things of enthusiasts, they call it, and other would be built for server. Like there are different classes. The server, basically you can easily find it by there are only two classes, one for consumer, one for enterprise. The enterprise components are tested to much higher standards. They will not let you overclock it, overvolt it or anything like that, but they can guarantee you that it will work 24/7 until its warranty time, which could be as high as 5 years. So there are different class. So you need to know what you want. You need to know what class is suited for you, and then you have to figure out the combination of hardware. Now we look at the assembled computer, which is every nerd's dream. We're gonna do this. I also have my own assembled system. So it's a very custom tool. You can tailor it to exactly what you want. Like there are people who spend thousands and thousands of dollars just to make a system to break, Cinebench benchmarking score. So you can do it. And there are people who built specific computer just for Bitcoin mining. You can do it. Assembly requires you to make perfectly tailor-made system for your very specific need. This is the best part about it. Second, because there is no hindrance to money, like how you spend it, you can have the best performance possible. Because let's say other systems will not allow you to put 4 graphics card. Here you can put 6 graphics card if you want. You can have a full block liquid cooling on of them. So performance wise, if raw performance is your target, like this is what you want to do, your system must be the most badass system in the land, you can do it only through custom built system. Now everything is fine and good, and you can easily see there are multiple layers of components. Some will cost $2,000, some will cost $500, some will $1,000. So there is a lot of leeway and more choices. However, because of this exact nature that there are so many choices, it's the biggest side effect of assembling a system is chaos. Now what I mean by chaos is not only related to money, the fact that many times people have no clear idea how much money they are spending on their assembled system, because there are so many little components that you do not count for. How many times you have seen people remove the budget for a keyboard, and then they realized, oh, they have a gaming system, now they need a gaming quality keyboard. Maybe you need it, maybe you don't, but you have to realize those sort of things are generally neglected in assembled system. So cost generally overruns by a lot. So you may be like, okay, I'm gonna spend $1,000, and you end up spending $1,200. That $200 came from extra things like little fan and like, oh, I did not think I needed a custom high power cooler for my CPU. Things of that nature happen. It's very chaotic and you cannot help it. Simply by there are so many objects here that it will happen. It's a simple fact of that. Now, that itself is a one-time hassle. It's like you figure it out one time, you're done. However, the second part, this is the real trouble for anybody who's doing living out of their system. It's not reliable, not because it's inherently bad, but simply because each component is not tested with each other. Like you may be like, neglect your motherboard's manual and be like, I'm gonna put a RAM. Now, awesome, but was that RAM in qualified vendor list? Yes or no? Like many people don't even know about who are very good system builder, but they do not know about QVL, qualified vendor list. So things of that nature simply does not mean your system is bad, does not mean your system is gonna die. It simply means it's not tested for maximum operational reliability. And if anything goes wrong, which happens, like things go wrong, you have a hassle to deal with at this point where you'll be like, okay, if my motherboard breaks, I have to go to Asus. If my processor breaks, I have to go to Intel. If my RAM breaks, I have to go to Corsair. So you can see this is the chaos aspect. This is why companies either buy assembled system from one central vendor who will take care of all these things, or they will directly buy from HP, Dell, Alienware, for this exact reason. Like a company cannot be asked to deal with this PC failed. They just want one guy to call up, like, okay, this PC failed, come and fix it. Like they want one point of communication, not like, okay, this system failed, okay, let's figure out what failed in it. Okay, so hard drive failed. Is hard drive inside warranty? Because if you build things like that, you may have a scenario where hard drive may have only 1 year warranty, your RAM only have 3 year warranty, your motherboard may have 18 month warranty. So you realize there is a lot of potential for chaos. So it does give you best performance and it does allow you to build perfectly custom tool, but be mindful, there is a lot of chaos into this and they don't even last very long. Then we come to the hated aspect of pre-built system. Now I will be very honest with you guys, in earlier days, as in before 2010, like it's not that hard day, like before that time, if you have looked at pre-built system, they were no good, basically flat out. They did not have cost advantage. They were not costing 5 or 6% more, they were costing upwards of twice or three times more than that. So you might as well buy Apple at that point. So they were not cost competitive. On top of that, they were not properly built. What I mean by that is like the guy who built must have built those sort of system was not like a guy who's in touch with the ground. Basically they had like super high-end CPU but shitty GPU, and they were calling it gaming CPU, gaming computer. Things of that nature has happened. They might have had a processor that was way too underpowered, but they had a graphics card that is like too overpowered, so they sold it based on like, okay, it has the latest and greatest graphics card, but the processor was acting as a bottleneck and you could not get the performance out of it. So there was a lot of genuine complaint that people had from pre-built system. However, in recent year, since the basically everything is getting gamified, the pre-built industry has picked up. Now we have HP, which has its own lineup specifically built for gaming. I don't think I have to mention Alienware and MSI also. So there are a lot of vendors that are putting some serious effort into this, and they are not doing the mistakes of their past self, where they are like, okay, processor is overpowered but RAM is too less. So they are balancing the system out. So now if you spend money, you will get the best performance. But consequences is a stock performance. So they try to build it one system that can handle a lot of people. So like this, I specifically like, this is the size of a normal UPS and it has almost full desktop grade capability, like including 3.5 inch hard drive, 1 2.5 inch SSD, 1 NVMe SSD. That's all in that, and full size desktop graphics card. So it was pretty awesome, but you can't just like ask them, hey, bump up the power supply so I can put a bigger graphics card. It has a processor that will not act as a bottleneck, but you can't do that because they will not allow you to change the power supply. So you still have some limitation. They give you a mold. In that mold, you can go around a little bit here and there, but you can't custom make it. Now, they offer the best reliability out there. Now, the reliability comes from the two factors, because A, they test it out. Like, if they give you a system that is like, you know, let's say 32 GB RAM, they test it out. Does that 32 GB read? Because there are scenarios where if you plug memory modules in your motherboard, it may not read. Like, it's a rare occurrence, but it does happen. And you may have a scenario where, let's say, your RAM module is like 25,000 hertz. It may be reading at slow speed at 1800. Now, Dell will take care of it. Alienware will take care of it. MSI will take care of it. But if it happens to you while you're assembling your system, you are on your own. You have to do the troubleshooting yourself. So for that reason, the reliability aspect matters. And they give you very good warranty schemes. Like, I had a Dell PC in India, in a small town, where whenever I had one dead pixel on my LCD, they came and replaced the LCD. I had a RAM malfunction, they came and replaced the whole damn thing. So this sort of thing is not possible for assembled system. So be mindful, if reliability is key, like if you are making a living out of it and you are like, okay, I need the best and the, you know, best performance possible, you can buy Alienware. Heck, for right now, the price to performance gap that used to be there is flat out gone. So flat out, if you compare HP Omen, MSI Nightblade or Alienware, like cost wise they are more or less same, if not these are cheaper. So I urge you to please pay a closer look at price to performance ratio. And not to mention, in Alienware you can find a dual graphics card system, which both graphics card will be liquid cooled. Tell me the cost of that. Like, just figure out the cost for yourself and then check the cost of this sort of system. Now be mindful, availability may be a factor of tax. In your local area may have tax. Like in India, we have some state that does have VAT, value added tax. In other states we don't. So please pay attention to that. So that may skew your pricing. But like, do you have time to assemble this sort of system where you have dual, GTX 1080 Ti liquid cooled processor that is liquid cooled, RAM that is tested, overclocking that is tested, having three hard drives, having two SSD, one NVMe with operating system installed? Do you really have that kind of time? Like, of course, Linus Tech Tips has, but you can see in his videos how much he struggles trying to make all this thing work. For this reason, pre-built systems are now a much better option than they used to be. So now it does come with a consequence that it has low performance. Like, you, even though the motherboard the Alienware themselves are giving you can support four graphics cards, you can't put four graphics cards in it. So it does come low performance. Now, when I say low performance, does not mean, you can only game it at, 60 hertz. They will give you a gaming system that, can rock 120 hertz display easily. But be mindful, if you are going for that Cinebench score, if you are going for that benchmarking, or if you are doing a render station on your own system, yeah, then I would urge you to reconsider this. However, if you are doing it for money, please look into this, because you have 1 point for warranty. If your system goes down, you can simply call one guy and be like, okay, my system is down, come and fix it. Like, you don't have to worry about, oh, my RAM is down or my processor is down or whatever. So for this reason, nowadays, pre-built system, is back with a punch. So this was my presentation on whether you should buy a pre-built system or a assembled system. I hope you liked it or learned from it. In that case, please leave a like, share it amongst your friend who may be interested in computers, and I would urge you to subscribe. Now, if you didn't like it, don't worry about it. You can dislike it, and I would ask you to leave a comment what you want to see in the next episode of Computer Wednesday. And if you are free, press the bell icon. Thank you for watching my video.